PPO5W Weapon Specialist Action, also known as Not Ironhide from iGear. Okay, so this thing is like shoebox size. It's nice. It's got a nice face art here on the side. Then it's got some white, like some CAD wireframe drawings here of the figure, which is kind of neat. Looks very techy. But do yourself a favor here. You gotta read this. I think this was very creatively written. I was laughing out loud at some of this stuff because it's all inside jokes and digs, and it's about third-party companies and stuff. So you gotta check it out. I think they did a really excellent job with this little bio. So right when you open this thing up, it comes in a double clamshell, which is it's very nicely packaged because it's very sturdy and it's not gonna. You know, he's not going to get banged up in shipping in this thing. It's a very nicely done. Now, you've got a nice glossy heavy card, kind of like you did on your little iGear Huffer. And it shows his tech specs bio here. But here's his instructions, and it's left out a few steps. Steps I found where there were hinges where things needed to get folded in and whatnot. So, kind of disappointing with the instructions. Really, the only disappointment of this figure is the instructions. But it does have some nice cross cells here. I've got these. We've reviewed these already. These guys are on pre-order. They should be in any time now. And then there's Gears and Beachcomber, which I'm looking forward to. They look really nice, as well as a Swerve and Outback. So, yeah, man, I can't wait for all these. Come on, iGear. Let's go. Heck frickin' yes. Ironhide, as he should be. Ironhide, G1 Ironhide, I should say, as he should be. I personally have waited for this figure to come out since the G1 cartoon, and that's no exaggeration. This needed to happen so much longer ago, and I'm very happy that iGear actually went and did this, because you want a G1 Ironhide, this is the Ironhide to get. So, most people want to see comparisons, mostly comparisons, and that's what I'm going to give you. So, here we have Ironhide, G1 Ironhide in hand. A little bit beat up and worse for wear, baby, but you know what? He still gets the job done. You can see just how much bigger our new, brand new iGear one is. This guy's metal, this guy's plastic, but this guy is heavy, just to let you know. I think this looks superb. I think this is absolutely excellent. This is all chromed out here. Very nice little update to this guy. Rubber wheels. Very nice touch. Very nice throwback touch. All chrome here up in the front. I'm digging that all day. I totally like that. And he's got like little chrome highlights around his, you know, like the gas tank, and the lights are clear plastic and see-through. I like this. I like it quite a bit. And yes, this is going to be a gush fest. So here he is with, I guess, this is Classics Ironhide. You can see the Classics version is a little bit longer. It's smaller though. It's a lot lighter than this guy. This guy's much heavier. This guy's a little bit more hollow. But yeah, Classics, the Deluxe Class Classics is longer than this guy. So if you get this guy in hand and freak out because you thought he was like masterpiece size, he isn't. When he transforms, he's in good scale with MP10. So yeah, this guy can fit in with the whole Classics line. I'll show you more. So he's right there with, you know, like the Sideswipe mold, the Hound mold, that kind of stuff. You can kind of see. I think he scales real well with them. Get some more guys in here. Here's Trax. Let's see what he looks like next to him. There you go, Bumblebee. Get right in there. Let's all get up on in there. Here you go. You need Prowl. Absolutely. Get him in there. So, yeah, just a mess of Transformers, Autobots rolling out and coming at you. This guy fits right in with him. I think he looks excelente. And just to show you what he looks like with a Voyager class figure, he's in good scale with it. I think he looks good with the Classics line. Really does. I think he's a good replacement for this guy, which I'm not a big fan of. And one more comparison. Here he is with, you know, your Classics Optimus. Now, I think this Classics Optimus is a little bit too small in comparison to my Ironhide. It doesn't look bad. This looks a little bit too big to that, I think. But really, I think the best scale, in my opinion, is this Optimus Prime, which is your MP10. This guy will be out at Toys R Us very shortly, within a month or two here, so check that out. This is the Takara version, but Yeah, I think this looks really, really nice. And, oh man, I can't wait to get my classics shelf built up and then show that collection off, because I think these are going to look real nice together.
Okay, at this point of the review, it's time to do the montage. That's the transformation montage, where I put some fun guitar music over it. I'm going to do that, but I'm going to try to keep as many steps of the actual transformation in here as possible, just so you guys can get a good idea of what it is and how this thing works. So, with that being said, let's cue that music. Ironhide! Look at this! Finally! Finally, finally! After all these years, we finally got a G1 Ironhide toy that looks pretty awesome. This is spot on, man. I'm totally, totally digging this. Got to love this thing. I'm telling you, this is going up on the shelf, the top shelf, man, next to my masterpiece, Optimus. And yeah, he's going to be his right-hand man right here, man. This is great. Now, if you guys have seen some of the other reviews, you will know that, well, people have been asking about what is going on with the extra hinges and this area right in here. As you can see, if you look at this guy, he's kind of, well, he doesn't look too bad. His aesthetic and his profile isn't too bad, but looks like these are supposed to fold underneath here because there is room for it to happen. Well, you can do that, and you gotta kind of be very, very careful because you're bending plastic at that point. So I'm going to try to show this on camera, and it is scary. So if you're scared of breaking a toy, avert your eyes or skip this next section. Okay, so what I do here is I kind of mistransform this guy a little bit, and I do whatever I can to try to clear away room to get. I get this panel underneath here. So it has a little bit of a hinge in the back here. You can see this if you untab it like this. It does hinge down a bit, but it doesn't hinge all the way. So I think a good fix would be to clear some plastic away on the inside to allow that to roll down a little bit farther. And then you could just do this, I guess, in a more non-scary fashion. But you can see right now I'm just kind of torquing and bending right now. So bear with me here, people, but you can tuck that in underneath there, and whoo, I'm sweating bullets. I don't want to break this, but for review's sake, I got to do it. We got to see this guy how he's supposed to look, and I'm kind of bummed that it doesn't just do this naturally and normally. Ooh, man, I got it. Whew. Ooh, nervous chatter right now. Let's look at it from the front. So it did clean up his silhouette a little bit here. It gave him more of a V-taper and gave Ironhide some bigger lats. Close up of that face, that is a perfect Sunbow cartoon G1 face. Loving that. Let's look at posability, and we'll do it really quick. Guy's totally posable. Ball joints here. He's got 360-degree swivels here. He's got this going on. He's got double-jointed elbows here. His hands can spin. He has a swivel up here, like an upper chest swivel, plus a waist swivel. He can also swivel down here. He's got upper ball joints here, so he can do this. He can spin at the knee. He can also bend at the knee. And his feet are on ball joints here, so you can pose them around and stand them how you will. And this heel spur can be moved as well. This dude is totally poseable and so cool.
Okay, so there is G1 Ironhide, and he's on the right, just so you're not confused. And you can see why I'm gushing on this figure. The guy on the left really, really needed to happen. That's an add-on head, by the way. Here he is in a lineup with some classics and generation stuff, and I think he scales absolutely perfectly with these guys. He's a little bit shorter than Inferno, but a little bit taller than the sports car robot. So yeah, man, spot on. He's going to look great on a shelf. And we saw this mold and how it was just about as long as he was in his car mode. But look how much bigger now he is when he's transformed. Same mold as Ironhide. Ironhide is Optimus' right-hand man, so let's get a couple of Optimi next to him. This is the, you know, the Voyager class generations Optimus. Here is MP10, which I think it might be a little bit out of scale. I don't mind that. I think it looks nice together, because I think they do look masterpiece quality. But I think the most in scale may be the Faith Leader. If you have the other eye gear, well, it was basically a scaled-down MP01, the Faith Leader from eye gear mold, then that, I think, might be the best-looking scale together. There's a reason this guy's called Weapon Specialist, so let's dive into his cache. Here's the blaster pistol that he comes with stored in vehicle mode. Big old movie-like cannons. Look at that. Can't forget about his arm communicator here, plus his little clip-on weapon thingy. Interesting. Got a big old chromed-up G1 homage missile-launching cannon that plugs into there or someplace on his arms. Of course, we have a mouthful of liquid nitrogen for you Decepticon creeps. Got a really cool serrated choking hazard here. Little clip-on communication satellite here. Pick up the NFL ticket. In case you're not softened up by the rest of those weapons, he does come with his own chromed-out spinny saw blade of doom. Another little G1 homage gun. Not that our boy would ever be so cowardly as to have to snipe at somebody, but he does come with a nice long sniper rifle. With a rotating barrel and rotating bipod. Very cool. And lastly, you have Neutral Face, which I have on him. You have Grimace Face, and you have Really Irritated Face. Overall feelings on this guy is that I have waited 25 years for this figure, and I'm very happy to have it finally. This completely satisfies my G1 Ironhide craving, and a good figure that did it a lot of justice. I think this thing is really awesome. For what you get, I think it really is cool. So thanks very much for watching, people. This has been Mitch Santona. Next up, we got Medical Specialist. So we're going to do a little side-by-side with that. We'll get the ratchet going. Yeah, man, go check out Second Channel Action. I got another video coming up soon, but I also have a contest on that. On that channel, if you have an Xbox and you like games, you may enjoy my next contest on that channel. But I do have a little giveaway coming up here soon as well, so just stay tuned, and I'm sure you will like something you see. Take care, guys. Arrivederci. Have a great weekend.